Morning, Charlie.
Hang on. 19. One more to go. Do this every day.
Why don't you put a pool in the cottage? Then you can raise my rent.
Then you'd owe me even more every bloody month.
I brought your painting back.
Oh. You've been telling everyone it's a forgery.
It is.
I've already had an offer. Sight unseen.
From our visiting American friends.
That's right. Bexham's family. They're trying to collect his stuff for sentimental reasons. Thanks. I knocked the price down for that, Nicole, I'll tell you that. What a darling.
It was Bexton's story. Did you know him?
No, not really. Sold him the house a couple of years ago. Retired engineer, I think. Died unexpectedly. Left the place to Betty Springer, his housekeeper.
Do you know her present address?
Of course I do. I'm handling the sale on her.
Well?
Huh? Oh, she went back to the Isle of Man. Amanda, I've told you before about swimming naked when there are people here.
Knock it off, Charlie. Lovejoy's seen me before. Apologize for my brother's behavior.
Yeah, he seems to think I kept some things of yours.
I can't imagine what would be worth keeping, but Eddie's real uptight.
So am I. Mind you, it might have been different if you'd been creeping around my bedroom last night.
I guess that would have been more fun, too. Why don't I buy you lunch?
Antiques are everything. Nothing else exists. When you hold an antique, you reach back through centuries. You touch the hand of genius. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Mm. When you hold an antique, you love it, because the love that made it shines through.
Right. That's why I'm a dealer. I suppose that's why you and Edward are dealers, too.
Is that what you think?
I think you're a couple of normal, healthy collectors ferreting around the English countryside in search of coins.
Well, you do seem to possess some sort of higher knowledge, Lovejoy.
Let's suppose you found a couple of Roman coins, and then you saw the pair that Bexton gave to the local museum and thought they were from the same batch, and being a naturally healthy pair of collectors, you liberated them. How am I doing so far?
Best movie I've seen in months.
And being coin dealers, there's naturally more where they came from, and somewhere in Uncle Jimmy's things, there might be pointers to their whereabouts. Spot a port?
No, thanks. If any of this were true, where would that leave you?
In the hunt.
But not necessarily in the lead.
I think my nose is just in front.
Well, then you should pick up the lunch tab, don't you think?
Certainly. Shit.
Ah, quiche, trout, wine, port. How nice. I suppose you're hand in glove with her and her brother now.
I might reappraise my position.
I'd talk to Dandy Jack first. He's in the hospital. Someone tried to kill him.
What?
Lovejoy? No, Stanley Jack, did you see him last night?
He'll live. He's more upset because his sketches are ripped off. He lost a deal with Lord Ryecroft. Did you bring the cash?
Yeah.
But my dad wants evidence of a pronounced improvement in my endeavours.
You will have it, Eric. There's a book here. Biographical memoirs of extraordinary painters. You read it before I get back.
Hang on, get back from where?
I'm going up north. Auction.
That cash is for your rent, Lovejoy.
I know it is.
Here, are you off to something? I want in if you are. Fair's fair.
You drink your coffee, Eric.
Ready's, Brian.
Wonders will never cease.
May I have an invoice?
My pleasure, boy.
Mrs. Springer.
Yes. How do you do?
I was just admiring the view.
Please come in. That's why Mr. Bexon was always so reluctant to leave.
I can't say I blame him.
It quite shook me, your phone call, Mr. Lovejoy. It's been years since anybody mentioned all that Roman stuff. Mr. Bexon wrote it all up in a paper and sent it to professors at Oxford and Cambridge. They just laughed at him. He was a very shy person, and that wounded him deeply. So, after that, he decided to keep it all to himself.
What did he tell them?
Mr. Bexon's theory was that while Boadicea was on the rampage, the Roman governor, Suetonius, had a kind of honeymoon here with a favorite mistress.
While he was supposed to be in Anglesey having a hard time with the Druids. Mm-hmm. Politics never change.
He said he'd found evidence of a small Roman presence.
The two coins he gave to the museum?
Yes, but he found a grave of some kind as well. This was before I became his housekeeper. There was an urn with ashes and coins and an inscription with the name Isbal. It was Mr. Bexon's theory that they'd been walking along the cliffs and she fell and was killed.
And Suetonius buried her here and then went back to the mainland to take it out on Boadicea. I can imagine what the professors thought of that.
Yes, they said he'd made it all up.
Well, he was a bit of a faker, not to say a joker.
Never malicious, though.